It's both defensive and offensive. CVS wants to get out of the business of just being a middleman. At $69 billion, this would be a record healthcare deal, valuing Aetna at about $205 a share, about 13% premium to Friday's closing price. But investors would get $145 in cash for that, $67 in CVS stock. CVS says it's already secured promises from financing from its banks and expects a deal could close in the first half of next year. For Aetna, coming off of a block deal to acquire Humana, this transaction is one of the only options, really, to leverage its assets and scale up as an insurer. For CVS, it's transformative. Buying a peer pharmacy benefits rival really wouldn't have done it, would have kept them in the middle. This gives them all of the assets they need to truly offer a diversified healthcare option that provides value. Now, the combined company would make them really sort of the biggest firm by revenues. If you look at their 2017 estimated annual revenues, they'd have about $240 billion on the top line. They'd have 22 million insured from Aetna, 90 million in pharmacy benefit customers from CVS, and they'd also have home care services, those 1,100 in-store clinics, and, of course, nearly 10,000 pharmacy locations. When you look at it side by side, if you move over to United Health and look at what United Health has, it makes them comparable in terms of size, and they'd be able to really compete on being able to offer a full-service package to large employers, to the government, and really pull out some of that middleman excess and offer true value and really be able to talk a lot to the pharmacy guys, the pharma guys, and perhaps extract better pricing as a result.
To pull out the middleman, I mean, that's kind of what they're messaging to say. It would be good for consumers if we can do that.
Yeah, but at the same time, what happens now is you've got some large employers, for example, Comcast. We have, on the one hand, we have insurers, and then we have the pharmacy benefits separate. Now you're going to get potentially Aetna, CVS together, and United Health saying, you know what, we're really going to want you to keep those two together. We don't want you to do it a la carte, and this is how we'll price it better. You would pay a price for trying to have more competition and use the different pieces separately. So for employers, this could kind of box them in to really have to go with one or the other.
One solution off the shelf versus trying to shop around. Like right now, we used to have Aetna. We don't anymore. We have United Health.
No, and we have United Health, and yet we have CVS as a pharmacy benefit. So our company decides to do it a bit more a la carte. Yeah. Other companies have gotten more benefit from being able to use the Optum side of United Health and the United Health benefits. And that's one of the things that has helped United Health grow. The other thing to think about is, you'll have this deal in the works. There's a lot of sort of moving parts going on in the pharmacy benefits space at the moment, right? Because Anthem wants to start its own pharmacy benefits unit, and they don't want to work with Express Scripts anymore. So if you're sitting here right now as a large employer looking at what you're going to do for 2019, you're going to have Anthem in transition. You're going to have CVS and Aetna kind of trying to put it together and work out the kinks as one company together. And then you have United Health that already has the one single option. So some benefit managers say, once again, while their partners are trying to make big changes, or rather their rivals are trying to make big changes, United Health continues to go in one direction.
Did you say anything about Amazon?
You know, Amazon is part of this here in terms of perhaps if they really do enter the pharmacy space, but more likely Amazon would enter the generic space. Right. That's not where the profits really are. Because at this point, a lot of folks can offer generics with those cash payments of $4. You don't necessarily have to be in network.
Although Amazon's probably a factor just in the retail end of CVS, too. And
exactly. So in the retail end. But now CVS becomes much more of a healthcare play than retail. So they're a healthcare play with retail. That's what differentiates them from United Health.
Hey there. Thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.